the sort of poison ivy's vine spreading.
The penguin's umbrella, like everything.
Penguin's umbrella.
So freaking epic.
I'm EW staff writer Chancellor Agard, and welcome to the final installment of On Set with Batwoman, where we'll be breaking down the season 2 finale, Power. And joining us today is the star herself, Batwoman herself, Javicia Leslie. Hi, Javicia. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, Chancellor.
I just realized watching this episode that, like, it's almost like exactly a year, I think like a week away from when you were first cast on the show. How does it feel to know that you came through an entire season as Batwoman?
I was literally thinking about that today. I was thinking about the finale coming up on Sunday and whatever I was going to do to celebrate it. Just because of the fact that, like, we made it through a whole season, but not only did we make it through a whole season, we made it through a whole season during COVID. So it's like, for all of this to have happened, all mm-hmm. this monumental movement with our show, to still be able to survive through COVID and truly be able to have dynamic episodes and amazing guest stars and, you know, cool, innovative directors during COVID is just such like a blessing. And it's been so much fun. It was so much fun getting to know the cast. It was so much fun kind of like diving into the story and, you know, learning the world of Batwoman on screen. And then of course it was so much fun to be able to play such an iconic mm-hmm. character and like interact with the world while I'm playing this character, because we were able to do like live tweets and lives on IG and things like that. So to be able to interact with the fans while we did this also made it super like amazing.
I'm curious because, since we're on the other end, I'm going to ask you this. When you joined, or at least after joining in like the beginning days of joining the show, did you know that like they would be reintroducing Kate Kane midway through the season, or were you as surprised as probably some of the viewers were when sort of she reappears in the back half?
No, Caroline Dries, our show creator, we had to talk about it because it really mattered that we mm-hmm. we took care of the Kate Kane storyline, the character. And so we mm-hmm. she told me then that she wanted to be able to, you know, revisit the story, revisit the character, give the character, I mean, that's the original Batwoman, so we really wanted to give the character its justice. And so I think we did such a great job, and hiring Wallace was like so cool because I feel like she just kind of like not only fit the part, but just like fit our family so easily, so quick. And so it's been really fun to be able to mm-hmm. be Batwoman while also still being able to play with the character of the original Batwoman.
I mean, yeah, in this finale, you actually, in the past several episodes, you've had like, you've gone toe to toe with her several times. But I think in the finale, you had like two really sort of hardcore fights with her. What was it like sort of shooting both of those fight sequences?
It was fun. It was, you know, the first one that the characters do is when she's completely just Circe. She still has her mask on, and that was like episode I believe like 12 or 13, something like that. And that was so much fun. It's actually one of my favorite fight scenes that has ever been shot on our show, just because it was just like a nonstop. We pretty much almost did it as like one long shot of just like forward movement. So that was our first fight. Then our second fight was inside of the Batcave, and that was really fun, but that was probably one of the most difficult ones because we had to kind of get around the fact that there's a tree growing like in the middle of the Batcave. So we're like trying to fight around it and making sure that we keep each other safe mm-hmm. and protected. But it was also really cool because now she kind of knows who she is, and she's dark and she's twisted, and she's able to like, you know, she's manipulated everyone. And so it's like, but then also Ryan wants to obviously disarm her, but she can't hurt her because she's Kate, you know, mm-hmm. that's Kate's body. It's just like, it's such a hard, that specific fight was really hard for Ryan because she did not want to hurt Kate, but she knew that she needed to protect her mm-hmm. team. But the fight in the finale mm-hmm. was kind of a moment of like, nah, forget that. Let's go. But also I think she did so much, you know, she attacked Sophie. She attacked mm-hmm. Luke and Mary. And it was just at a point where it's like, this has to stop. Plus, you know, I finally figured out how to stop you. So the fight scenes were really fun. I know the last fight scene, it was outside, and Wallace and I always have so much fun when we're doing these fight scenes because, like, we're both really into stunts. So it was just really cool to be able to play with somebody like that.
And I mean, I'm curious, I want to back up a bit and look at this finale as a whole. I mean, when you first got this finale script, how did you react? I guess what jumped out at you when you sort of read through it the first time?
I really love how all the storylines tied up. I love Kate's goodbye because it felt like it wasn't like a goodbye forever. It kind of felt like, okay, you know, I need to go figure myself out. I need to go figure out who I am in this new body, in this new world, you know, and I need to find my cousin Bruce. And I trust that Ryan can take care of Gotham. So it's like, to me, a real passing, you know, of the torch, a real passing of the cow, you know? And I don't think we ever really had that throughout the season. We never had a moment where Kate and Ryan were able to really, like, pass the torch and say, it's your turn, you know? I also love, honestly, the twists, you know? For me, I think that I always had a feeling when we started this season that we never really addressed Ryan's biological parents, and that would always end up being something that would get addressed in a very, you know, tricky Gotham way. And so now that we know that there is a possibility, or maybe just it is the truth, that Ryan's mother, her biological mother, is still alive, I just am so excited for season three because this is just a whole world that we'll be able to enter. And then also, I just love where the crew is. Mm-hmm. I love how we ended it. We have Batwing. Like, that's so freaking dope. Camris Johnson is our first live action Batman Batwing on Batwoman. And it's just like so cool to really be able to like be a part of the history that the show is making. And I think that the finale just does an amazing job kind of like tying all those stories together.
You mentioned Ryan's the knowledge of Alice dropping this somewhat cruel knowledge that Ryan's mom is actually alive. I guess, how do you think that will affect like Ryan moving forward? I guess, do you think Ryan will actively want to seek her out? Or I guess, how do you think she's feeling about this?
Bombshell? If I had to even say how I would feel, the first thing I would want to know is, you know, why did you give me up? So I think that there's always going to be that thought in the back of Ryan's head. But I think that to know that there's any person that she's like blood related to still alive that she could find, I think it would be very important to her. I think that her having a mom, a mother-daughter relationship with someone is very important for Ryan. So I know that that's probably going to be a huge part of her focus for next season, is figuring out if Alice is lying. And if Alice is telling the truth, then finding out where her mother is.
And I mean, with this finale, I think this finale is sort of about Ryan. I mean, she has that speech before the parole board of sort of accepting her, how that she found her power, you know? For you, but then like this finale, I mean, she starts in a place though of like being sort of unsure of herself because she's lost the bat suit. She doesn't know how she's going to take Circe down. For you, what was it like to sort of go through this journey with her in this episode of her sort of finally like reaching that point? She's like, nah, like I'm powerful. Like this wasn't a fluke. I know what I'm doing. And sort of like, I guess finding her confidence again.
I think, you know, I kind of feel like, again, that was like a journey that her and I had in common. Just trying to figure our way through this, you know, like, where do I exist in this? And am I worthy to exist in this, you know? And I think that her losing the cow taught her that she didn't need the suit to be the dynamic hero that she is. It's like, it's completely within her, you know? And I think that going into the future, that's going to give her the strength to know that she doesn't have to have the suit to be the hero. And heroes can come in all kinds of packages and shapes and sizes and colors and things like that. And so I think that was like the perfect boost of confidence for her to really empower herself. So when she goes into the parole hearing, it was really just about, you know, you guys never saw me. And the problem when people don't see you for who you are, you start to doubt who you are. And I think a lot of Ryan's life was her doubting her awesomeness, her strength, her dynamic, you know, like her really doubting herself because other people didn't see her. And I think going through the whole thing with losing the suit and then being able to fight Black Mass and Circe without the suit strengthened her to realize that there was nothing wrong with her from the start. She's a strong, fearless mm-hmm. hero from the start, with or without the suit. And, you know, whether or not these people see her is no longer her problem because she believes in who she was and who she is. And so when she stands up for herself in front of the parole hearing, I just thought, I was so excited about that scene. Like, I was really, really excited about that scene because I just felt like it was such a hero moment outside of the suit, you know?
Well, yeah, because I remember at the beginning of the season, you were also talking a lot about how important it was to see, I think in the context of our first interview, if you said how important it was to see Ryan fighting outside of the suit, but I think also, again, you also mentioned sort of talking about episode 4, about how, like, it's important for, like, especially the young Black girls and Black boys watching the show to, like, see you outside the suit also being heroic and yeah. sort of giving them, like, again, letting them know, like you said, like, you don't need the suit to be a hero.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And putting a face to that.
That's the point, you know? That's the point. When you watch these type of shows, mm-hmm. you know, every little kid that's watching it, they believe in every part of it. As an adult, we can separate ourselves from the story mm-hmm. sometimes, or we intentionally lose ourselves in the story, you know? But kids, they are completely 100% in it. And I think that having these moments, like Ryan standing up for herself as Ryan, really teaches the kid that they don't have to put a mask on to finally stand up for themselves, you know? And yeah, I think it's like so subtle mm-hmm. and probably not even intentional, but it completely, it just completely makes that point that you don't need any of that in order to stand up for yourself or any of that in order to stand up for someone else. Mm-hmm. And I love that we started with the parole officer and we ended with the parole officer.
Yeah, I mean, I love the scene where Ryan tells the parole officer that she's Batwoman and has to fight her way out of the precinct. Yeah. I thought that was a really cool moment as well. I think that must have been two episodes back now. And I'm curious because of COVID. I know that has definitely significantly reduced the amount, I'm assuming, of fan interaction you've had. But I guess in the past few months though, have you had people come up to you or? When they've seen you out and about and sort of be like, oh my God, Batwoman, or what have you, have you had a chance to have any of those fun, like, in real life fan interactions?
Yeah, they're so much fun. We get to take pictures, but then more than anything, we get to talk about like what this casting means. I've had people tell me what they were doing when they heard the news, and these weren't people that I knew. You know, they would say, mm-hmm. oh man, I remember when I was watching the news and I saw this casting. And just how dynamic this was. Because I just think that the cowl, the cape, it has such a coveted place in so many American homes or just world homes, you know, like we all have our own attachment to the story of Batman. And we haven't yet mm-hmm. been able to see us in that cowl. And so to be able to see that, even if you never watched the show, just to know that that exists, it's kind of a moment that I think everyone kind of felt like, oh, that's really cool. So whenever I meet people and they tell me where they were when they heard the news, I mean, that's just really, that's dynamic. And I just love that we're able to make a difference while having fun creating the show. It's really cool. And I honestly just look forward to when things open back up and we can do Comic-Cons like in person and things like that. So I can really like get in there and meet people and have conversations and take pictures and talk to them.
And thank God a season 3 is on the horizon. I'm curious, what are your hopes for season 3? What would you love to explore? What would you love to do next season? And have you shared any of these ideas with
Yeah. Dylan? I for sure I'm super excited to team up with Batwing Cam. I think it's going to be so much fun. It's funny because Cam does a lot inside, so he doesn't know the struggle of filming outside in Vancouver at nighttime in the rain. So I just look forward to watching him suffer with me. I also super hyped for like Ryan to have a love interest, like one that she gets to really explore, because I feel like with Angelique, It was like Angelique came into her life and then just immediately got pulled away because of all the Black Mass drama and things like that. So I look forward to like Ryan having her love story and just exploring that, you know, as an actor to ever play like romance. It's so much fun. It's so much fun. It's so beautiful. It's so tender on screen. So I look forward to that happening next season. And honestly, just more action, more, you know, Gotham, more grittiness, and just to see where the storyline goes, you know?
I mean, I feel like you won't be disappointed in terms of the more Gothamness of it, because I think, because I know, as you've talked about many times, like, you are a huge Batman fan, and, like, this finale ends with, like, a pretty good cliffhanger or just tease for next season it with the sort of Poison Ivy's vine spreading.
The Penguin's umbrella, like,
Penguin's umbrella.
So freaking epic, like, literally, like, a lot of, like, your epic Batman villains, we have all of their weapons and they've all been released into the water and into the river. And like, you know, people are going to find it and you're going to find the effects that these weapons have on these normal Gotham citizens that then end up becoming like these super villains. And it's just going to be so much fun. Like, I can't wait. I'm excited because we're about to start shooting season 3. And I can't wait to read the scripts and to see where it goes.
Awesome. I'm excited to watch it too, especially after that cliffhanger. Javicia, thank you so much for joining us today. And also just throughout the season as a whole, I really appreciate it. And everyone else watching this, please make sure you watch Batwoman season 2 when it hits HBO Max at some point later this year.